So I'm here at Goldsboro Books in the heart of the city centre in Brighton, and I'm going to be speaking to Jude to find out what's going on about this new shop in our city. Here it is.
Hello, welcome.
Hi Jude, so going to take us for a little tour around Goldsboro Books, aren't you, today?
Yes, of course.
Just tell us a bit about Goldsboro Books, because it's a bookshop, but not as we know it. It's quite unique, isn't it?
Yes, so Goldsboro Books was actually founded around 22 years ago in London. That's where our original shop is, by David and Daniel. And this is actually a shop that we just opened a year ago during the pandemic. So actually we're quite new here, but we specialize in hardback first edition books. And the large majority are signed by the authors.
Yeah, exactly. And they're quite collectible now, signed books, aren't they? Maybe that's a Harry Potter kind of... trend catching on, where kind of first edition Harry Potters are, go for thousands, don't they?
Yes, we actually have one of them in store.
Yeah.
But so collectible books are starting to really take off, and they're really nice as gifts, or if you actually like books, it's a nice addition to your collection.
Are kind of bookworms in Brighton, Jude? Because there's quite a few independent bookshops, aren't there, or kind of smaller chains. We really love books, is that right?
I think so, yeah. I think in Brighton, but in the UK generally, actually, because in a lot of other countries, there's not so much, there's not so many people who read books in general, to be honest, because I know from the countries I've lived in, British people like books, which is nice.
Yeah, and what's good about this is that it carries on a trend of like people actually reading a physical book rather than online. Because I know Kindle's done well recently, but
yeah.
I for one like to see the book and to kind of have creased pages.
I'm really the same. I like the smell and just the feel.
Yeah.
Of an actual book, yeah.
So just in terms of signature, I mean, does it have to be personally signed, or how's it work with this kind of the signature process?
Yes, so usually we try to get in authors in store, not in Brighton, but in store we usually try to get the signatures done when the author comes in and they do the signing. But because of the pandemic, it's a bit difficult to do that kind of stuff, so sometimes we have to ship the books. In here, and just behind me, are the older edition books. So they are especially curated by our founders, so Daniel, David, and members of our team as well. We search for the first editions of older books, and we try to keep them in as best quality as possible, and not damage them, because obviously they're much older. But this is them, and there's another one over there.
Yeah, you've got some classics here. So we've got a lot of their old books, which... I'm aware of someone actually over Christmas that had a signed Roald Dahl book. They are very collectible, aren't they, the old Roald Dahl books?
Yeah.
I've also seen you've got J.D. Priest, and you've got Jack Kerouac as well here. So, yeah. I mean, are these kind of presents, or do you find people actually buying them to collect them, or is it more kind of a gifting?
I think it's both. Honestly, right. I think it's both, because a lot of people buy them either for their parents or their children, kind of vice versa. And a lot of people buy them for themselves, collectible people who are really passionate. There's a lot of, for example, Agatha Christie fans.
Yeah.
We don't have the books anymore, obviously, because they sold, but a lot of fans of Agatha Christie came in for Christmas.
Yeah, great. I mean, what is it about reading? Is it escapism, do you think? I mean, what do you personally like about reading? It kind of being taken out of your kind of your...
Yeah.
reality into a kind of different world?
Yeah, I would say escapism is a factor in some people. For me, I just genuinely am fascinated by how authors manage to create worlds. I'm somebody who reads books that are very rich in world building, so I'm fascinated if you can create an entire different culture or world, and I that's what I personally like. Yeah.
Just before we finish up, how do we get to Goldsboro Books then? I'm just based on Ship Street, aren't you? So just tell us a bit about how people can come by in the opening hours.
So we're very near the seafront, so if you literally just turn off in the corner, you can see us. And if you're walking through the lanes, I mean, we're in a very central location, so you can literally see the big Goldsboro Books sign.
Exactly. Great gifts, I have to say. So thanks, Jude, thanks for talking to us today. All the best for the future, and happy new year.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks.
Too. Thank you.